A reading from the second book of Kings. Naaman, the army commander of the king of Aram, was highly esteemed and respected by his master, for through him the Lord had brought victory to Aram. But valiant as he was, the man was a leper. Now the Arameans had captured in a raid on the land of Israel a little girl, who became the servant of Naaman's wife. "If only my master would present himself to the prophet in Samaria," she said to her mistress, "he would cure him of his leprosy." Naaman went and told his lord just what the slave girl from the land of Israel had said. "Go," said the king of Aram, "I will send along a letter to the king of Israel." So Naaman set out, taking along 10 silver talents, 6,000 gold pieces, and 10 festal garments. To the king of Israel he brought the letter, which read, "With this letter I am sending my servant Naaman to you, that you may cure him of his leprosy." When he read the letter, the king of Israel tore his garments and exclaimed, "I am not a god with power over life and death, that this man should send someone to me to be cured of leprosy. Take note, you can see that he is only looking for a quarrel with me." When Elisha, the man of God, heard that the king of Israel had torn his garments, he sent word to the king, "Why have you torn your garments? Let him come to me and find out that there is a prophet in Israel." Naaman came with his horses and chariots and stopped at the door of Elisha's house. the prophet sent him the message, "Go and wash 7 times in the Jordan, and your flesh will heal, and you will be clean." But Naaman went away angry, saying, "I thought that he would surely come out and stand there to invoke the Lord his God, and would move his hand over the spot and thus cure the leprosy. Are not the rivers of Damascus, the Abana, and the Parfer better than all the waters of Israel? Could I not wash in them and be cleansed?" With this he turned about in anger and left. But his servants came up and reasoned with him. "My father," they said, "if the prophet had told you to do something extraordinary, would you not have done it? All the more now, since he said to you, 'Wash and be clean,' should you do as he said?" So Naaman went down and plunged into the Jordan 7 times at the word of the man of God. His flesh became again like the flesh of a little child, and he was clean. He returned with his old retinue to the man of God. On his arrival, he stood before him and said, "Now I know that there is no God in all the earth except in Israel." The word of the Lord. Athirst is my soul for the living God. When shall I go and behold the face of God? Athirst is my soul for the living God. When shall I go and behold the face of God? As the hind longs for the running waters, so my soul longs for you, O God. Athirst is my soul for the living God. When shall I go and behold the face of God? Athirst is my soul for God, the living God. When shall I go and behold the face of God? Athirst is my soul for the living God. When shall I go and behold the face of God? Send forth your light and your fidelity. They shall lead me on and bring me to your holy mountain, to your dwelling place. Athirst is my soul for the living God. When shall I go and behold the face of God? Then I will go to the altar of God, the God of my gladness and joy. Then I will give you thanks upon the harp, O God, my God. Athirst is my soul for the living God. When shall I go and behold the face of God? Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I hope in the Lord. I trust in his word. With him there is kindness and plenteous redemption. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus said to the people in the synagogue in Nazareth, "Amen, I say to you, no prophet is accepted in his own native place. Indeed, I tell you, there were many widows in Israel in the days of Elijah, when the sky was closed for 3.5 years, and a severe famine spread over the entire land. It was to none of these that Elijah was sent, but only to a widow in Zarephath in the land of Sidon." Again, there were many lepers in Israel during the time of Elisha the prophet, yet not one of them was cleansed, but only Naaman the Syrian. When the people in the synagogue heard this, they were all filled with fury. They rose up, drove him out of town, and led him to the brow of the hill on which their town had been built to hurl him down headlong. But he passed in the midst of them and went away. The Gospel of the Lord. God's ways are not always our ways. Our ways are not always God's ways. Naaman found this out. And one of the reasons that Naaman was hesitant to go to the Jordan was, I think the other rivers were closer, but they were also cleaner. The Jordan River wasn't that clean. And so that could have been one of the reasons that he resisted. But be that as it may, it reminds us of how we expect God to do things the way we want him to do it. And it doesn't always happen that way. That's frustrating in our challenge of faith, but also an encouragement to us to go deeper and to seek more and more answers. I remember many years ago in my parish, one of the women's prayer groups had been praying for one of their members who had cancer and was probably dying. And they would fill me in every week before Mass and say, well, she's not any better, but we keep praying for healing, that she will be well. And the next week she died. And they came to me in the sacristy and said, Father, she died. But she was still healed. She was healed according to God's plan, not ours. And those women taught me a lesson and an insight into this reading about Naaman, but also other conditions in our life. Sometimes, too, we look for big miracles, a big show of display of God's power, but it doesn't always happen that way. Most of the time, it's in small ways or in ordinary ways. And so our coming together in worship is a beginning of a healing process as we are united around the table of the Eucharist, where we are healed completely as we come closer and more fully united to God, or in our sacrament of reconciliation, an ordinary way, and yet there are many miracles that take place through that sacrament. Say with the anointing of the sick. Anyway, it's a reminder to me that I gotta look for the ordinary things and see God's work, God's hand in action. And I pray that I and we all can continue to be more aware of the ordinary things that happen but are still done at the hands of the healing of God. That's why I made my report about the baptismal font. It was overflowing. I didn't know if Naaman was here or not. Okay, let's stand and pray. That the church may continue to be purified and sanctified through the grace and mercy of God, let us pray to the Lord. That all of the ends of the earth may know the saving power of God, we pray to the Lord. And that those who experience rejection or failure may find hope and strength in the gospel message, let us pray to the Lord. That the grace of God's word and sacraments may heal and transform all of us in the image of Christ's love and mercy, let us pray to the Lord. And for all the faithful departed, especially the member Richard Mavison, may they rest in eternal peace in God's heavenly kingdom, we pray to the Lord. Merciful Father, you sent your Son to save us. Look with favor on the petitions we now offer. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. perpetual offering, which earth has given, human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Heal us of our illness. Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. May what we offer you, O Lord, in token of our service, be transformed by you into the sacrament of salvation. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by your gracious gifts each year, your faithful await the sacred Paschal feasts with the joy of minds made pure, so that, more eagerly intent on prayer and on the works of charity, and participating in the mysteries by which they have been reborn, they may be led to the fullness of grace that you bestow on your sons and daughters. And so with the angels and archangels, the thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat his bread and drink his cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Bernard, our Bishop, his auxiliary Joseph, the clergy, and all your faithful. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let's show each other some sign of peace. Take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, say a word, and my soul shall be healed. blessing of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.